John Kane.
He in trouble? Now, I want you to know he is a good boy.
He ain't in no trouble, Miss Nettie.
Then what the police want with him?
This ain't no policeman, Miss Nettie. This is Dr. Thomas. I told you, remember?
Of course I know. I remember Dr. Thomas.
John Kane, Miss Nettie, do you remember anything unusual about him?
No. That's what I told Mr. McCullough when he proposed him for the scholarship at the Tubman Institute in Marin. I said, John seems very ordinary, but don't you be fooled.
But John didn't go to Tubman.
Mm-mm. Isn't that a shame? You know, I remember he came to see me before he left school. I stressed the importance of the opportunities at Tubman. But he said he didn't have time. I remember that. 16-year-old boy just smiling and saying he didn't have time. His name was John, Anna Kane's boy.
Yes, Miss Nettie.
If he goes to Tubman, he can qualify and be of service to the people. But he told me I can't teach them. That's not my job. Well, I gave him the sharp edge of my tongue, all right. I said, John, your father is away working, and your mother needs you. And he said he couldn't help that. He had to go. I asked him when he's coming back. When the wind comes again.
He's back now, Miss Nettie.
Oh, isn't that nice? Although I do believe the scholarship to Tubman is already awarded.
I'm afraid it is.
You ask him to come to see me. I want to see his journal.
Journal?
Mm-hmm. I gave it to him for going away present. I told him, John, you keep your eyes open and your mind busy and you write down something worthwhile every day. It's a lovely journal. Brown morocco leather with gold design and a pretty silk ribbon to keep your place.
Did you write anything in it, Miss Nettie?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I always do write the same thing. To, you know, whoever it is, truth like beauty is in the eyes of the beholder. Sign N.W. But Nettie, we lock a court. I do hope he hasn't lost it.
He's still got it, Miss Nettie.